This is the third DVD of the series of cruise ships in 2015. In this case, they've been taken in Southampton, in the Adriatic, and around Norway. There are 20 ships on this particular DVD, either coming into harbour, going out, or tied up alongside. This picture of a foreign two-masted bark, whose name I couldn't get, was taken whilst filming in Southampton. So let's start. And we start with the Aegean Odyssey, which we saw coming into Corfu. The wind was exceptionally strong that day, and I saw something I'd never seen before. Behind Voyager, in which we were travelling, was the Oceana docked, and she had both her bow thrusters and two tugs holding her into the wharf. When we came back from our day out in Corfu, which had been very pleasant, we found that the entertainment staff and some of the deck stewards had made a corridor along the wharf to make sure that we walked between that and didn't get blown off. One of the tugs was released from duty on the Oceana to guide the Aegean Odyssey in safely. Now, some of you will have travelled in P&O's Artemis. She was sold in 2011 and became the Artenna. Here we see a different ship called Artemis. She's a little cruise ship that goes around the Adriatic and she carries 50 passengers. She's seen here in Dubrovnik. So now we come to the Costa Neo Classica. I assume the Neo means new, but she isn't new, she's the old Costa Classica, and she still carries that name. She must, however, have been smartened up on a recent refit, hence the Neo. The weather in the early morning was not very nice, but it did cheer up later in the morning. In fact, the sun came out and the temperatures rose to a respectable 22. which was good for the new guests coming on and not so good for the guests going off as we were on Voyager. In total, there were three Costa ships in Dubrovnik, or coming in and going out from Dubrovnik whilst we were there, and Costa Deliosa was one of them. I wasn't able to get any film of her sailing. I missed that whilst I was ashore. However, I did walk along the dockside while she was there and take some more film. We saw the Costa Romantica in Piraeus. I wanted to film her sailing, but I felt sure it would be at the same time as the lifeboat drill I was required to attend on Voyager. I was right. However, by twisting round and trying to look as if I was paying attention to what was being said, and has of course been said many times before, I was able to film Costa Romantica through one of the lounge windows. Disney Magic, filmed by my friend Brian Simmons in Stavanger. I'm afraid I have to say these ships hold no magic for me, neither do most very large liners or cruise ships. I'm a small ship man myself. Still, there must be a market for them, and I'm sure the children who go on board have a lovely time. Somehow I wish Disney had stuck to theme parks. In this clip, you can just see the rear end of the New Britannia. Disney Magic takes over 2,800 guests. You really do have to give it to them. They come up with all the fun of the fair. Also in Stavanger at the time was Pulmanto Cruises Empress. She takes over 2,000 passengers. Our next ship is the All Leisure Group Hebridean Princess. She only takes 49 guests, all in extreme comfort. She was built originally as a Calmac ferry. She normally cruises around the Scottish islands, but she seems to be branching out a bit lately, and she's seen here entering Foy Harbour. She is one of the few ships that can go in bow first. Since the demise of the royal yacht Britannia, and because of her love of the Scottish Islands, Her Majesty the Queen has chartered Hebridean Princess on two occasions, to my knowledge. We can watch now as the pilot comes on board. Thank you. having spent the day in Foy, Hebridean princess now makes her way out to continue her cruise around the British Isles. Another small ship, only 800 tons bigger than the Hebridean Princess, this time taking 200 passengers, is La Belle de l'Adriatique. She is seen here first, moored in Piraeus. Later that night, she slipped out, just as the light was fading, past the Hellenic Seaway ferry. She'll pass many others before she gets out into open water. By way of contrast, here is the 95,000-ton MSC Magnifica. She's coming in to Dubrovnik. We watched from the upper decks of Voyager as the MSC Magnifica turned slowly round and came in stern first into her berth. another MSC ship, this time the Poesia, slightly smaller than the Magnifica. She carries the same amount of passengers, that's 3,013. Having watched her come in the morning, we were surprised when, at about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, she left again. Her time in Dubrovnik, about 6 hours. The weather in Dubrovnik that day was really appalling. The day before, they'd even made the television screens, it was so bad. Clearly, some of the guests on board would have been very disappointed. When you only have a short time in these foreign ports, you really want to see as much as you can. If it's pouring with rain, really doesn't help. Fortunately for us, we'd been to Dubrovnik before, and we restricted ourselves to a walk along the wharf, filming the ships that were in, and we picked a time in between the heavy showers. Well, the MSC Poesia is on her way now, and it seems that there are fairer skies ahead. We had moored in Hvar. Very shortly afterwards, I saw this four-masted ship approaching. We both watched her for a long time as she came in and anchored close to us. The Royal Clipper takes 224 guests in comfortable accommodation. We sailed before Royal Clipper, and as we passed her, we noticed that she had a bathing platform off her stern. In the next port, there was also a sailing ship in, this time the Sea Cloud 2. Sea Cloud 2 only has 96 passengers, and I believe it's exceptionally well fitted out. Unfortunately, in this day and age, with all the security that these ships have to have, you don't get the chance to nip on board and have a look. Here we see Silver Sea's Silver Cloud coming into Puy during the summer. These pictures were taken by Peter Smith from his house. We were to be berthed very close to Sea Cloud in Venice 3 or 4 months later. Like Silver Cloud, Silver Wind takes 296 guests. She too is seen here in Fowey, but this time she is leaving port rather than coming in. Silver Wind drops her pilot. Finally, in this sequence, we see the larger Silver Whisper, which is, as you see, 28,000 tons. She takes 388 guests. Silver Whisper is about to depart Fowey. We get a good view of her as she makes her way through all these yachts with the green fields behind her. Another clipper ship, this time Star Clipper, we saw her in Piraeus on our last cruise. I had hoped to take pictures of her sailing, but she sneaked out when I wasn't looking. I have a son who lives and works in Hong Kong, and he took these pictures. Star Cruises operate Star Piscis. They generally run short cruises, which cater for a largely Chinese clientele, but not entirely, and they do a lot of gambling, which is not allowed in mainland China. Star Piscis and Superstar Virgo, seen here docked in Kowloon. We see here Star Pesky's about to sail with a backdrop of Hong Kong Island. Hong Kong Island is a lovely sight lit up at night with all the skyscrapers along the waterfront and up the hill towards the peak. There's constant traffic as the Star ferries go from one side, that's Kowloon, to Hong Kong Island on the other side. And other ferries scuttling backwards and forwards to Aberdeen and Lantau and other little islands around Hong Kong. And now we see superstar Virgo. She's in the distance, about to enter Hong Kong Harbour. And this picture shows her coming in to Hong Kong early in the morning, having completed her cruise. Kowloon is in the background. Superstar Virgo takes 2,975 passengers. Royal Caribbean International's Voyager of the Seas is also seen in Hong Kong. She's about to sail. The Voyager of the Seas takes 3,840 guests. We saw World Odyssey in Piraeus. Now, she's not actually classified as a cruise ship. She's run by Semester of the Seas. She was the Deutschland and was sold in 2015. She's a university ship. The students study as they go around the world to various ports. Well, I'm going to end this film with our little ship Voyager. We join her in Piraeus. The joy about Voyager is that she's small enough to get into a number of little ports which the larger cruise ships can't get into. Well, that brings us to the end of Cruise Ships 2015, Part 3. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I look forward to seeing you in 2016.